Hey, good morning, everybody. Man, it's great to be with you here on, what is this, Thankful Thursday? It is, and man, the week's flying by, and every time flies for me, and so it just always seems like every time I turn around, I got something going on. But you know what we can do? You know, right? You know, you've heard it. We can rejoice and be glad. Why? Because this is the day the Lord has made. Let's get that 2 minutes started. Man, every time... And, you know, let me restart. You know, I do this off the cuff. So sometimes I get my words all jumbled up and I'm thinking, oh my gosh, that was awful. And I want to delete it, but I never do. And when I think about that, somebody says, man, it's the greatest thing ever. You know, in my quiet time this morning, I looked at another devotion. I get a devotion email and I really haven't read them much, but from, cause you get a lot of stuff, you know, through email. And this one was from, kind of a famous pastor named J.D. Greer. And man, it just really, I just thought it was great this morning. And so I shared it there as part of the quiet time devotion this morning. And basically what it says is that, you know, God, when he created the earth and he created it that first time, there was just this darkness. And it says that right in verse 1, Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, that there was this darkness that was just over the earth. And that as God spoke, that light became part of the earth. And so this morning, as I can look right over my camera here, right out into the yard, it's light and it's daylight and you can see and you don't need headlamps. And so, because why? Because God created that, didn't he? Well, the same thing can happen in our lives, is that as sin and addictions and broken relationships and heartache and trouble come into our lives, what can happen is a darkness can overwhelm our heart, and we become, you know, I call it a stony heart. J.D. Greer called it a dark heart, and that's probably a better term. It's one I'm probably going to start using, is that we can have this dark heart in our lives, and we can forget all about God, and we can go on our way, and, you know, a lot of people that's going to listen to this, you know, they're going to say, well, boy, this don't apply to me, but it can creep up on you so easily that you can just, next thing you know, you're just wallowing around in the pig pen of sin. And man, you got some sin you're holding on to, whatever it is, whatever is gripping your life. And the only way, I'm going to tell you this, the only way to break the grip of that sin, you know, somebody said something with the Celebrate Recovery is a wonderful program. It's a 12-step program that follows Alcoholics Anonymous or Addictions Anonymous or whatever that is called. And so, but really what it comes down to is the Word of God. The Word of God, as I've often said, is like this living organism that it just really, I mean, it is alive. And as we study the Word and as we read the Word and as we look at the Word, you know, it just becomes alive to us and it speaks to our heart and it's the Spirit of God speaking to our heart and it changes our lives. And so, man, if you're following down that path of just this dark heart path, man, I just really, really encourage you just to begin to start digging into the Word. Use that quiet time today as the quiet time Bible reading, because that is talking about a thankful heart. And we want to have that thankful heart toward God. And that right there, that the Word, the light of that Word will start to penetrate your heart. Just those few verses will just make a huge difference in your life. And so, man, if you're struggling today with some sin, you know, we all do, by the way, even me, and you're struggling with that, man, just begin today to just dig yourself down into the Word. And somebody just called me a few minutes ago saying, man, I want a Bible. And boy, I helped them out and they got them one on the way. And I'm excited about that because I want that same thing for my life. I just love the Word of God. And I want you to fall in love with it too. Amen. Amen. Hey, Thankful Thursday. Hey, and those Bible verses are all about thankfulness. Why not use that on Thankful Thursday today? God bless you. See you next time. Bye.